Assalamu alaikum dear students, welcome to all of you in Introduction to Network Lecture 3. In our previous lecture, we were discussing about networking devices and we categorized our devices into three main categories. The first one, your end user devices, second one, your networking devices, and thirdly, your security devices. Along with this, we also discussed about the symbols. But in our today's lecture, we are going to discuss the second most important pillar of your networking, which belongs to your medium and media. Anything which we can use to connect our devices with each other and share data among them, that is known as medium and media. Remember that there are two main types of medium, guided medium and unguided medium. Guided mediums mean your cables, that can be any type of cable like your coaxial cable, twisted pair cable, or your fiber optic. And on the other hand, second type of medium is your unguided medium, also known as untraceable medium, which means that your wireless connectivity or your wireless signals. But remember that either we are using guided medium or unguided medium, actually on which our data is traveling from source to destination, that is known as media. So there are three main types of media which are being used in our network. The first one is your copper media. The second one is your glass media. When we are using fiber optic, we are actually using glass media. And third one is your wireless transmission or any type of signal, as you know that most important standard of Wi-Fi. If we are discussing about our guided medium or we are discussing about our cable media, here you can see that we have three different options. The first one is your coaxial cable. This coaxial cable is normally not used in our network nowadays, as it supports maximum 10 Mbps support, but nowadays our network minimum support speed is 100 Mbps. That's why in most of the organization we don't like to use this coaxial cable. This coaxial cable has two different types, thin net and thick net. Thin net stands for 10 base 2 and thick net stands for 10 base 5. Means when you are using thin net, you can cover 200 meters distance and the speed of data will be 10 Mbps. And in the same way, when you are using thick net, again, your speed is still 10 Mbps, but here you can cover a lot of distance, which is 500 meters. But as I have discussed that, not being used in our network. But a single question before you, if anyone asks you where we like to use this cable in our network nowadays, remember that for voice or video communication, we are still using this cable in some points or in some organizations. The second one and most powerful cable of your network is your fiber optic. Very good cable, giving you very high speed and covering a very large distance. It has two different options, single mode and multi mode. When we are using single mode fiber optic, our data is moving in only one direction and we need to use two cables, one for sending and one for receiving. But it's also known as a long range cable. When we are using this cable, we can cover a very long distance. This cable is normally used as a submarine or also used for interconnectivity of different branches or countries or between cities and so on. The next type of fiber optic is multimode. Multimode cable is slightly thick as compared to single mode. And when we are using multimode cable, actually we just need one cable, and this cable both sends and receives our data between two nodes or between servers or clients and so on. But this cable as I discussed, is very good for speed and distance, but it's a costly solution. Most of the organizations, due to high cost, not like to use this cable in their normal local area network. So what's an option? Remember that the most commonly being used in our local area network cable is twisted pair cable. This cable also supports a very high speed, and it's a very economic solution, as it's not a very costly solution. When we are using twisted pair cable, why it is called twisted pair? Remember that inside this cable, there are totally 8 cables, and they are divided into 4 pairs. And these pairs are twisted with each other so that there cannot be any distortion or data loss within the cable. This cable has two main types, STP, shielded twisted pair, and UTP, unshielded twisted pair cable. Here are some characteristics of your copper medium. Remember that if you are using coaxial or twisted pair, actually you are using copper media. But if you are using fiber optic, you are using a glass media. So the characteristics of copper media are before you. There are some benefits and some drawbacks of using this cable. The first one is transmitted on copper cable as electric pulses. Remember that when we are using copper media, our data is traveling in the form of electric pulses. Attenuation. The longer the signal travel, the more it deteriorates. Means this cable can cover maximum 100 meter distance. After 100 meter, our signal goes lost. But to resolve this problem, we can use some devices like switches. As in our network nowadays, our switch gives us a very good benefit. As switches are not designed for this purpose, but still they do this thing for us. They regenerate our signal. If we want to cover, for example, 1000 meters by using twisted pair cable, yes, we can cover this. How we can do this? After every 100 meter, we will deploy between them a switch. A switch will perform the function of a refresher or regenerator. He will regenerate our signal, and our signal will travel next 100 meters, and in this way we can cover 1000 meters. All copper media must follow strict distance limitation. Remember that it's very important to implement your distance limitations. The next thing is electromagnetic interface, EMI, and radio frequency interfaces, RFI. These are the two main problems who can damage or destroy our data signal when we are using electric cable. Means if our data is traveling in the form of electric cable or electric signal, these two factors can affect to destroy our data signal or can become the reason of our data loss. To counter copper cable wrapped in shielding. So remember that if you are facing EMI or RFI problem, in this scenario, you need shielded cable. Means you need STP cable, shielded twisted pair cable. But if you are not facing these problems, you can use normal UDP cable, mean unshielded twisted pair cable. The second problem is crosstalk. As you know that there are 8 cables within single cable, and there a signal is traveling between them. This distance can the signal inside this cable can affect each other. So the disturbance caused by the electric or magnetic field of a signal on one wire to the single in an adjacent wire. Mean if the 8 cables destroy the signal with each other, this problem is known as crosstalk. And to cover this problem, opposing circuit wire pair twisted together. Remember that these twisteds are not useless. Actually, these pairs are twisted with each other to overcome your crosstalk issues. As much the pair cable is twisted, more has more twist, and that is very good. If it has less number of twists, definitely it can be affected from crosstalk. So there are main three types of copper media used in our network. When we are using copper media in our network, that can be in the form of coaxial cable, UTP, untwisted shielded pair cable, and shielded twisted pair cable, and STP, your shielded twisted pair cable. Coaxial cable consists of, here I have discussed with you, not being used on a large scale, but still being used in some organization. Here we will are going to discuss, there are many different types of connectors when we are using our coaxial cable. That can be BNC connector, N-type connector, or FT connectors. Not going in a large discussion as it's not being most likely used in our network. Next thing with your UTP cable. UTP cabling is the most common networking media terminated with RJ45 connector. Remember that there are two types of connectors, such like RJ11 and RJ45. RJ11 connector is used for telephone connection as it has four pins and it is a smaller size connector. On the other hand, which connector is being used in our networking? Normally for a twisted pair cable, that is RJ45 connector. This connector is a larger size as compared to RJ11. And inside you have eight connections, mean you can connect eight cables with them, as our twisted pair cable has eight cables. Used for interconnecting network host with networking devices such as switches. Okay. The next thing is consists of four pairs of colors coded wires that have been twisted together to help protect against signal interference from other wires, mean from crosstalk. Color codes aid in cable terminations. STP cable also provides better noise protection than UTP. STP cable is significantly more expensive and difficult to install, and it also uses RJ45 connector, as the cable is same, just there is extra coating or magnetic coating inside it to work against EMI or RFI. Copper media are susceptible to fire and electric hazards, so be careful about this problem. Here are some extra properties of your UTP cable. Consists of four pairs of colors coded copper wire that have been twisted together and then encased in a flexible plastic shield. So here you can see that there are four pairs and each pair has two cables. The first one here you can see white, orange, and orange. Second one is white, green, and blue, and blue. The third one is your white, green, and pure green. And the last one is your white, brown, and brown. When we are using UTP cable, remember that there are many different standards of UTP cable which is available in the market. So there are three main standards of UTP or STP cable available in the market. The first one is your CAT3, the short form of your category. So category 3 cable used for voice communication, most often used for phone lines, as this cable supports maximum 10 Mbps speed. So we can use this one cable, or we can use coaxial cable for video or voice communication. But for data communication, which grade minimum we can use, that can be your category 5 or category 5E. When we are using this category, we can get a speed from 100 to 1000 Mbps by using Cat 5 or Cat 5e. These are two standards within same standard. The next standard is your Cat 6, used for data transmission. And here we can get a speed of 10 Mbps to 100 Mbps, not ending this, from 100 to 1000 Mbps. And even this cable can support up to 10 GBs, okay? So we can get a very high speed and we can cover a good distance, and it is also a cost effective cable. That's why this cable is being used in our network. But remember that not used for covering a long distance. If you need to cover a very long distance, you have only one option, and that one is your fiber optic. Here you can see some connectors. As we discussed that, which connector we like to use or we have to use for twisted pair cable, that one is your RJ45 connector. Here you can see that this one is your RJ45 connector, and here we have pinned 8 cables inside it. This is the actually jack or socket fixed on wall or in switches or available on our even our laptops. You can check this Ethernet port, and we plug this connector RJ45 inside this port or inside this Ethernet port. When we are using UTP cable, there are some testing parameters. Please keep these matters in mind if you are using UTP or STP cable in your network. The first one is your wire map. It's very important. The second thing is your cable length. The third one is your signal loss due to attenuation. And the last one is your crosstalk. As we have discussed all these things previously, you may can consult internet for these problems in detail, but these are important problems which you should keep in mind when you are like to use this cable in your network. Here you can see that by using this cable or twisted pair cable, you can use two types of color scheme. Although you can use any color scheme you like, but all those color schemes which you would like, that would not be any standard. So if you want to make any standardized cable by using this FTP or UTP cable, you have to follow these two standards. The first one is your 568A standard, and its color scheme is white, orange, white, green, green, white, orange, blue, white, blue, orange, and white, brown, brown. If you are using this color scheme, actually you are going to use 568A standard. And the second color scheme is your 568B. Here the color scheme is white, orange, orange, white, green, blue, white, blue, green, and white, brown, brown. Here the important point is why we need these color schemes. Remember that we need two types of cables in our local area net. The first one is your straight cable, and second one is your cross cable. Yes, what are these straight and cross cable? So first of all, I'm going to discuss straight cable. If you are going to use same color scheme on both ends, for example, this one is my cable, and on both ends, if you are using, for example, A standard 568A and same color scheme on other end means 568A on the other side, it will be a straight cable. And its standard will be 568A standard. In the same way, if you are using color scheme, both on side you like to use 568B color scheme. If you like to use this color scheme on both ends, again, your cable will be straight cable and your standard will be 568B standard. It means that If you like to use same color scheme on both ends, the cable will be a straight cable. And straight cable is used to communicate between different layer devices. Here the next question is layers of devices. Remember that our networking devices are categorized into three layers. Layer 3, layer 2, and layer 1. These layers we will discuss later on in OSI reference model, but at this point, just remember that mostly our networking devices belong to layer 3 and some devices belong to layer 2. If we like to use layer 2 devices with layer 3, layer 1 devices with layer 2, or layer 3 with layer 1, it means that we are using different layers devices to connect with each other. We would like to use, or we have to use, this straight cable. This straight line also is the symbol of straight cable. But if we like to use same devices or same layer devices on both ends, means layer 2 device want to connect with other layer 2, layer 3 with layer 3, or layer 1 with layer 1, in this scenario we need to use cross cable. And the symbol of cross cable is this one. This dotted line stands for cross cable. But the question is here, how we can make this cross cable? Very simple thing before you is, if you use this A standard on one end and this B standard on other end, which cable you will create, that will be your cross cable. Means this cable is here, and on this end I am, for example, using 568 A standard, and on the other end I am going to use 568 B standard. If you will use this color standard, 568 B standard, this will be your dotted cable and this will be your cross cable. So the point is here, if you will use same color scheme on both ends, it will be a straight cable, and straight cable is used for connectivity between different layer devices. And if you will use different standards, mean A on other end, B on other end, A on first end, B on second end, that will be a cross cable, and this cross cable is used to connect between same layer devices. So dear, thank you very much for today's lecture. In our next lecture, we will discuss more about these things. For today's, thank you very much.